हेलो वेलकम एवरीवन, वेलकम टू दी मास्टर कैंप फॉर सॉलिड वर्क्स ट्यूटोरियल्स सीरीज। इन दिस ट्यूटोरियल सीरीज वी विल ट्राई टू लर्न सम ऑफ द सॉलिड वर्क्स मॉडलिंग, ओके, फ्रॉम द सीएनसी मैन्युफैक्चरिंग पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू, एंड देन वी विल ट्राई टू सिम्युलेट द सीएनसी ऑपरेशंस using MasterCAM for SolidWorks software. This MasterCAM for SolidWorks is a special edition of MasterCAM which is provided as an add-in inside the SolidWorks. And if you have SolidWorks, okay, installed on your PC or laptop, okay, then you can download the MasterCAM for SolidWorks software, okay, from the MasterCAM website. So that is available for students and academicians for downloading purpose and exploring. Okay, so it is available, that can be downloaded. Now in this first tutorial, we will see a simple drilling operation. Okay, we will see two different types of drills. That is, one will be a through hole and the second will be the hole with some depth, okay, so it won't be a through hole. So these two drilling operations we will try to simulate using the MasterCAM for SolidWorks, and while doing that I will also explain what options are most likely to select in all these categories, and then we will try to verify the selected operations, okay, using the MasterCAM simulator. Using the MasterCAM simulator, and once we simulate, okay, once we simulate, then also we will generate the CNC codes for the particular tool path which we have generated. So this activity requires you to gather the knowledge which you have gained during the actual machining operations, okay, during your third semester maybe. Okay, so you need to bring all those memories of manual machining on milling machine, drilling machine, as well as lathe machine, okay, because all those things will be required in order to set up the simulation case on these, on this MasterCAM for SolidWorks software. So we will get started. I will be first demonstrating the modeling feature of the SolidWorks, in which we will first create the part and then we will go on to the MasterCAM for SolidWorks environment and try to generate the tool path, and then we will simulate the tool path. So let's get started. I'll start with a new part. Now while we are trying to create a model, that is a 3D model for CNC simulation purpose, okay, on the SolidWorks using MasterCAM for SolidWorks, okay, I would prefer creating the part in the top plane. Okay, I would prefer creating the part in the top plane. Okay, that generally aligns the plane of MasterCAM's top plane, and it is just like the top plane of the work table. So top plane of the work table on any CNC machine is recognized by XY plane, and the depth of the part is the perpendicular direction to it, which is the Z direction. So that's what we will try to match over here. So first I will select the top plane and sketch. This part is going to be a simple rectangular part. So I'll use this method, corner rectangle method. I'll create the rectangle and I'll give the dimensions. So the dimensions are going to be 120 by 80. Okay, 120 by 80. And I will extrude this in the downward direction. So this is by default the top direction, which is positive z direction. Okay, positive z direction. But we want to extrude it in the downward direction by amount, let's say 30 millimeters. Okay, I am using MMGS as the unit system over here. So all the dimensions are in millimeters. Now what has happened, this is my top plane. So when I select top, okay, this is the top face of my part is going to be my top plane. So the perpendicular direction up as I move is going to be my positive z dimension, and as I move downward, okay, towards the depth of the part, it is going to be the negative z dimension. So if I have to specify what is the depth of this part, it is going to be minus 30. Okay, it is going to be minus 30 according to this coordinate system. So if I have to instruct the tool, okay, to carry drilling, okay, in the z direction from z equal to 0 to, let's say, z equal to minus 31, then it is going to be a proper direction and it is going to be a proper instruction to the tool. Okay, proper instruction to the tool. So I want two holes, okay, just to demonstrate the drilling operation, in which one hole is going to be a through hole and second hole is going to be a hole with specified depth. So I will select this hole, normal hole. Size I am keeping as 510. The hole is going to be through all. Okay, position I'll select this. Okay, and then I'll specify the dimensions. So from here the hole is at exact 40, and from the left end the hole is again I would say 40. Okay, now as you can see the hole is fully defined. Okay, hole is fully defined. I'll say okay. So this is my first hole. Using the hole wizard, I created a through hole, as you can see over here. I want another hole. Okay, this time the hole diameter is 20 mm. Okay, it is not a through hole. It is not a through hole. It is a hole with depth of 21. It is a hole with depth of 21. And I'll select the position here and I'll say smart dimensions to confirm the position. This is 40 and this is also 40. Okay, now as you can see my hole is fully defined. I'll say okay. Now, as you can see, this is a hole with depth of 21 millimeters. So you have this bottom point. You have this bottom point. So if you actually try to measure the depth, okay, this point, the depth is not going to be 21. The depth of 21 is still here. Okay, depth of 21 is still here, and then followed by whatever the tip of the drilling tool is. So that is why we have chosen the hole wizard and not the cut extrude method, because we want to drill the hole. So that is very important. Okay. Now once the part is ready, just an effort to save the part. Okay, so I'll say I'll give some proper name. Okay, I will save the part every now and then. Okay, as we all know, the softwares, even though we are running them on a machine, that is laptop machine or personal computer, okay, it's always better to save them. Okay, we don't know when electricity might go off or some unexpected error might occur. So it's always better to save periodically. Then once the part is ready, see the part dimensions are 120 by 80 by 30. Okay, 120 by 80 by 30. If I just switch on the annotations, as you can see over here. Yeah, so this is 120 by 80. And let's say in the depth is 30. Okay, depth is 30. So that we will see from here. So this is 30, which is the total depth. This is the 21, okay, which is the depth which we have mentioned, okay, for the second hole. And the diameter is 20 mm. Okay, diameter is 20 mm. And also the angle, okay, with which it is going to cut the angle of the drilling tool is also mentioned over here. So then we will move into the master cam environment. So as you can see, you can add master cam from these options and then add in, and then here you can see master cam 2021 for SolidWorks, and here I have active add-ins. I have just clicked this. Okay, so you can click this once you start the SolidWorks. Okay, or you can have this every time the SolidWorks loads. Okay, this add-in will also load if you click here. Okay, so it's up to us. So I'll say okay. Once okay, you click on that add-in. Okay, it might take a minute or two to load the master cam. Okay, because it requires all the graphical memory, okay, to load all the options of master cam. So you just have to be patient. Okay, we come to this master cam toolpath manager. Okay, we come to this master cam toolpath manager. Okay, and we directly try to expand the properties. Okay, try to expand the properties. So the default is the machine group 1. Okay, remember we are doing the CNC programming over here. Okay, CNC programming for drilling operation. Okay, so the method is, if you have a CNC connected, okay, into your network, okay, or a computer is operating CNC, okay, then on that computer you can generate the CNC code, and then that code can be supplied to the CNC machine. Okay, so it requires a CNC code, okay, CNC code, which is a G-code M-code, okay, G-code M-code of the toolpath. So if we have to do that, okay, we first have to generate the code. Okay, we first have to generate the code, and if we have to generate the code, then we first have to create the cutting operations. Okay, create the cutting operations. So what we do over here is, we first create the end part, okay, which is just what we created. Okay, 120 by 80 with depth of 30. It has two holes, 510 millimeter through hole and 520 millimeter hole with 21 millimeter depth. Okay, so this is the final product that we want, so that we have created. Now what we will do, we will assign a raw material workpiece, okay, surrounding this part. And we all know, okay, if we have to create a part, let's say of 120 by 80 by 30 depth, then the raw material piece should be of larger dimension than this. Okay, should be of larger dimension than this. Then only we will be able to remove the unwanted material and have a very good surface finish part. But in this particular operation, we are only going to study the drilling operation. So the drilling operation, okay, we are not going to concern about the extra raw material in the XYZ direction, okay, for this particular part. Okay, because that, in order to remove that, we will require milling operations. Okay, so contour milling operations are required, that we will study slightly later. So we will be setting the raw material of exact same dimensions. What is the difference between the raw material and this part? Okay, the raw material won't have these holes in them. Okay, raw materials, or the raw material will not have these two holes drilled in it. Okay, that is going to be the only different part as far as the raw material for drilling is concerned. So that we can do from here, and as you can see, we set the top plane, okay, as the plane for creating the first sketch, and we extruded it in downward direction. So this is the coordinate system of master cam. So you have this as x, you have this as y, and this is positive z going up. So this top plane is at current z equal to 0. Okay, and as I move downward, okay, I am addressing the depth of part with negative z coordinates. Okay, so we'll open this file. So here all the settings are available. So you have this toolpath directory. Then you have machine toolpath copy. And you have tool libraries. It has many tools available. It has mostly all type of operations available. And the defaults are the mill machine, that is milling machine. You can change this. Okay, there are two types of machines. Either it is a milling machine or it's a lathe machine. So mill default that is the first machine. Okay, it will be by default available. Okay, if you want to change, you can change it from here. Okay, so output comments to NC file, output operations comments to NC. So NC is a numerical control file. So the output is a .NC file. Okay, output is a .NC file, which is going to be a CNC code, which can be finally supplied to CNC machine to carry out the necessary operation. Then we come to the tool settings. Okay, we'll give some program number, let's say 1000 will be the program number. Okay, feed calculation will happen from tool. So tool library has all the tools and it has all the values associated with the tools as well. So let's say high speed steel or carbide tool. Okay, then it will have default values of feeds, okay, default values of RPMs, okay, etc, etc. If you want to change, you can change it from user defined. Okay, so if you click on user defined, these options gets activated, and if you have a specific requirement, okay, then you can specify your own speeds over here. Okay, since this is the first case, so we'll stick to defaults, that is from tool. Okay, then toolpath configuration, you can say assign tool number sequentially. Okay, that is a good option to have. So tool numbers will start from T01, T02, T03 and so on if you are changing tools frequently. Okay, then warn of duplicate tool numbers. Okay, so if we are assigning tool number sequentially, okay, this option automatically is negated. Okay, it won't generate duplicate tool numbers. Use tools step pick coolant. Okay, that is also possible to have, or we can specify these properties from the toolpath manager as well. And search tool library when entering a tool number. Okay, that is also not required at this point of time. Okay, we can save. Okay, if we are doing repeated operations, we can save multiple time carrying out similar operations by putting on some of these options. Then advanced options, override defaults with modal values, so clearance height, retract height, feed plane, etc, etc. Yeah, I will explain this slightly later. Then the sequence number, so from when the program CNC program is a block of instruction, so every block will have a number which is called a sequence number. So the sequence number you can set to start from 0 or you can have any number. Okay, default the value has said to be 100, so the line number will start from 100 and it will increment by 10. So first line is going to be 100, second line is 110, 120 and so on. So that's what it means. So we'll keep this as default. We'll can change the material. So we will change the material from here. So I've clicked on select and source, I will say mill library, and here I have various materials available. So I will select steel, that is stainless steel 303. Okay, so as you can see, the material got changed. The material got changed even though we did not specify material at the SolidWorks environment. Okay, remember, this material is being applied as a stock. So now what MasterCam does is, MasterCam has nothing to do with, actually it has nothing to do with what is the exact property of this SolidWorks part which we have created. What it requires only an outline to create a stock, okay, according to the outline. So the part acts as an outline. okay, with no properties being transferred from SolidWorks, okay, as far as the materials are concerned. So material property is not transferred to MasterCAD. Even if you specify some material over there, okay, it will not be transferred over here. Okay, you will still have to select material, and that will be the MasterCAD material, okay, which can be selected from this option. So just remember that. Then we come to the stock setup. Okay, since it's a simple rectangular part, okay, simple rectangular part, what we will do, we will select the corners, okay, and specify the total stock. As you can say, stock plane is by default, we have just viewed that it's a top plane. So just to confirm it, it's a top plane. Shape is a rectangular shape, okay, and I'll select the corners. So when I click on corners, okay, you have to select the diagonally opposite corners. So this is the first point and this is the second point. This is a diagonal, okay, major diagonal. If it's a rectangle, it will have, okay, basically four diagonals, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so you have to select, you can select this and this, you can select this and this, okay, any corner you have to select, but make sure it's a diagonal point you are selecting. Once you say okay, now as you can see, 80, then x is 120, z is 30. So it has got the stock options, okay, the stock box it has created by only specifying the corner points, okay, and the stock origin is here. You can also change this, okay, you can also change this. By default, the stock origin goes at the center. If you want, you can change this by this option, okay. So now stock origin is x0 y0 z0, okay. Stock origin is at the bottom left corner. The bottom left corner. So this much is required in the properties, that is tool settings and stock setup. I'll say okay. So my stock setup is done. Now I will be requiring to initialize the particular toolpath group. So this toolpath group, when I right click, okay, I will be available with mill toolpaths. Okay, mill toolpaths. So as you can see, there are these many mill toolpaths available. Okay, some of them we might have not seen because those are pretty advanced toolpaths offered by advanced machines. Okay, the default machine for this MasterCAM is a 5-axis milling machine. Okay, so 5-axis milling machine can have various toolpaths. Okay, so which are listed over here. We will require pretty basic toolpath right now, which is a drill. So I'll click on drill. Now what it asks for the reference where the drilling needs to be performed. Okay, so the reference that you need to select is always the top plane reference. Okay, because then you can specify the depth accurately. Okay, and then you can specify also the retract distances, then clearance distances accurately. So since these are two different drillings, okay, I cannot carry them with a single tool. So what I will be doing is, I will be selecting first the first edge, which is the edge 1, okay, which is the 10 millimeter diameter. When I say okay, it opens the 2D toolpath manager. It will open the 2D toolpath manager, and in that we are going to select the drill. Then we will go and select the tool. Now we know that the tool that we require is 510 mm. Okay, so as you can see in this, all 20 mm diameter tools are available. So I'll go to filter. Okay, these many tools are there in the MasterCAM tool library. So all the first tools are end mill cutters, end mill flat, end mill spear, end mill bull, face mill, okay, radius mill, chamfer mill, etc. And from here you can see drilling tool starts. So this is a drill, then this is a reaming tool, it's a boring tool, okay, tap RH, tap LH, then center drill, then spot drill, counter bore, counter sink. You can specify your own tool and add it over here. You have engrave tool, brat drill, high feed mill, etc., etc. So these are pretty advanced, okay, as far as the five axis milling machine is concerned. So we want drilling tool, okay, and here the filtering options are available. So okay, if I say ignore, okay, if I say ignore, then it displays all the drilling tools available of all the diameters, as you can see, right from 2 mm to, let's say, 59 mm. Okay, 59 mm. So it may be slightly difficult to select from. So what we do is we click on filter, we give the filtering method, so equal to, let's say, 10 mm, and say okay. So when we say that, it only displays the tools with 10 mm diameter. So how many tools there are? There are two tools with 10 mm diameter. So we'll select the solid carbide drill. There is also HSS or tin drill. So we'll select the first one, that is solid carbide. I'll say okay, and it appears over here. Okay, and it appears over here. Then I will be going to the holder. Okay, now unless you have any specific requirement for the holder, okay, we can keep this default holder. Okay, we can keep this default holder. But if you are using a specific machine of specific make, okay, then according to the configuration mentioned, okay, you can select these many types of holders. There are many holders available. Okay, many holders available. So that is possible for selection. Okay, now this option is used. The stock option is used when you have some stock, okay, the material is above, and later on you require to use some face milling, let's say, and remove that material, but the drilling needs to be performed first. Okay, so in that case you can use the stock operation and specify there is some stock above the drill, okay, which is not going to be useful at this point of time. Okay, cut parameters, it's going to be a simple drilling operation. Okay, simple drilling operation. So we will not be changing anything. You can have different drilling operations. So drill, counter bore, peg drill, chip break, tap, bore, then rigid tapping cycle, fine bore, etc., etc. Okay, let it be simple drill right now. We'll directly go to the tool axis, is going to be 3-axis. Okay, so this is what the example of 3-axis. If you go to 4-axis, this is what the 4-axis means. Okay, and if you go to 5-axis, this is what the 5-axis means. Okay, so our all holes are on the XY plane only. So this is going to be a 3-axis. Okay, then we'll go directly to linking parameter. This is very important property. Make sure everything is mentioned in the absolute coordinate system. Remember, there are two coordinate systems when we talk about the CNC programming. Okay, when we have to write the manual programming, so we talk about the G90, G91, that is the absolute and incremental system. So in absolute, we are talking about the absolute coordinates, and incremental, the coordinates will keep on changing depending on the current tool position. So it's better to keep everything in absolute mode, because we have already specified the bottom left corner point as the origin point. So this is all absolute. We'll first specify the depth. So click on the depth and select this bottom curvature and say okay. And as you can see, it will register the depth as minus 30. So that is proper. And top of stock will override the selection, which was already 0. So it is 0. And retract I will keep as, let's say, 15. So retract is this distance. After the drilling is complete, by how much distance the tool will come up. So this is, that is the 15 mm distance. I will also switch on the clearance and I'll keep it as, let's say, 50. Okay, I'll keep it as 50 because I know there are no say hurdles. Okay, there are no hurdles as far as the XY plane is concerned. Okay, everywhere the Z value is same, that is 0. So 50 mm is also sufficient. If you have steps in between, then perhaps you would try to increase the clearance distance. Okay, that also I am keeping at absolute. So as far as the drilling operation is concerned, the linking parameter is a very important option. The second most important option is tip compensation. Now we know that the hole which we want to drill is a through hole, So this tip compensation has to be specified for through holes. So what it does, it brings the tool further down, because remember we have selected this as minus 30, this is our 0 and this as minus 30. So if I say this is minus 30, the tool's tip point will be coming towards this minus 30. Okay, and if we stop there, then I will have an unfinished hole. Okay, and there will be burrs remaining, okay, in that hole, which needs to be removed. So if we don't want to, let's say, repeat the operation, we can switch on this tip compensation and ask the tool to further come down by this breakthrough amount. Okay, by this breakthrough amount. So this breakthrough amount can be slightly larger, let's say 1 millimeter, to confirm that the drilled hole will be a through finished drilled hole. Okay, so I'll keep it as 1 mm. Okay, this tip angle is 140, but if you remember, the tool, the drill hole which we drilled, okay, had the tip angle of 118. So we can match this tip angle with the geometry that we are having. Okay, so this is 118 degree, this also is 118 degree. So now we have matched it. Okay, we have matched it. So in the home and reference plane, so this tells us that the home position of the tool. So home position of the tool is at x250, y-250 and z250. So z250 is far, far above. Okay, so we are clearly away from the part. Okay, clearly away from the part. So that's okay. Then as far as safety zone is concerned, okay, not required right now. Again, as I said, it's a simple part. It doesn't have any steps. In planes, again, we have already selected top plane. So everywhere you can see master cam top. Coolant is very important. So I'll switch on the flood type coolant. Okay, and that's it. So we need to set these many operations. I'll say apply and okay. So when I do that, as you can see, some toolpath is marked over here. The toolpath is marked. So this is the retract, the clearance distance. This is a retract distance. So retract distance is, this is a toolpath mentioned by blue line. So this is a path wherein the spindle is going to be on. And when I am trying to move the tool to the clearance distance, I will switch off the spindle and then it will go up. Okay, so most probably when we want to change the tool, okay, we will use the clearance distance. So at clearance distance, we will replace it with some other tool and then carry the further operation. So now the next step is to verify the selected operations. The next step is to verify the selected operations. So click on that. Okay, once you click on that, another window opens, and that will be the window wherein we can simulate the operation. Okay, we can simulate the operation and see whatever tool paths we have generated are accurately applied or not. So this is a master cam simulator, and as you can see, this is a stock which we have built on the end part which we have just created. Okay, it doesn't have any hole right now. Okay, it doesn't have any hole right now, and I will go there again. So as you can see, this master cam simulator opens. It can sometimes take time, because it has to load it, okay, the another GUI, and then this is the workpiece that we are seeing. So in the visibility mode, I have tool on, workpiece on, okay, stock on. If you want, you can switch off the workpiece. You don't have to show the workpiece. Okay, you can only keep the stock, because that is what we have created in the master cam. Now when I click on the see, this verify mode is on, and this is going to simulate the operation. So this is the tool which we have selected. So when I say play, it performs the drilling operation. And as you can see, this is a through hole it has drilled. Okay, and it displays all the other important aspects. machine name y-axis VMC. The total time it displays. Okay, it is going to be a very fast operation because it has to travel a very small distance. So feed length, total length that it is traveling, then feed time, rapid length, and etc. All the other options. Okay, NC code is G81. Spindle speed is also mentioned. As you can see, since we are using all default values, you might say these are pretty small amount of times. Okay, but when we will use some user defined values, at that time it will showcase the proper information. This is just the first exercise. Okay, so this is as far as the first operation is concerned. So I'll close this, and now we will carry out the second operation, that is the second drilling. So again I'll right click, go to mill tool parts, again go to drill. Okay, same thing we have to follow. Only thing is the second part I have to select, that is second curvature. I'll say okay. 2D toolpath manager opens. The tool that I have to select is not now 10 mm, but it's a 20 mm drill. Okay, so I'll go to filter, I'll change here 20 mm, I'll say okay. Now I am able to see all the 20 mm drills. So I'll select solid carbide drill 20 mm, I'll say okay, and this has been selected over here. So solid carbide drill 20 mm. As far as holder is concerned, I'll keep all the same settings. Okay, I'll not change the holder. Okay, cut parameters are also same. I'll directly jump to the linking parameters. Make sure everything is absolute, and I'll select the depth from the this point. Okay, so even though we have specified depth as 21, okay, the actual depth happens to be minus 27 because it has that tool tip. Okay, that is going to be the final depth. Okay, so we have to select this. Then top of stock is going to remain the same. So this is my top of stock, which is 0. Retract distance, let it be 50. Clearance distance, let it be 15, and then clearance 50. Okay, now I don't require tip compensation. Okay, because this is not a true hole, so that is very important. Let the home reference position be the default position, and let the coolant be flood type coolant. So all the things are done. I'll say apply, okay, and just for the safety I'll save the part. So now I have both the operations, as you can see, tool paths being shown over here. Then I'll go to the, I'll select the second one, and then I'll go to the verify selected operations. Okay, verify selected operations. Yeah, let it load completely. Now this is the workpiece. Now since we have only selected the second operation, so it is not going to show the first hole which is already drilled. Okay, so we'll see it next time when we will select both the operations, and then it will show both the operations one after the other. So all again similar information. Okay, as you can see over here, G0 is the NC code. I'll say play. It goes down, drills the hole, and comes up. And as you can see, this is the depth that it achieves. Okay, this is the depth that it achieves. Okay, I'll close this, verify selected operations. Then from this, select all operations. I'll select both the operations, and then I'll click on verify selected operations. Okay, we'll wait till all the stuff gets loaded. Okay, enhancing the model is over, and then we will start the simulation, play the simulation basically. So now as you can see, two steps are shown. orient this part accordingly and play the first drill and the second drill. Okay, first drill and the second drill. This was very fast, so we can just slow down the speed a bit, let it load completely. Just slowed down the speed. And I'll again play this. As you can see, this drills the first hole, then change the tool, drill the second hole, and that's done. So now I have both the drilled holes. One is a through hole and the second is a hole with specified depth. So this is as far as the drilling operation, okay, on MasterCam for SolidWorks is concerned. Okay, so we'll close this window. And the last step which is remaining is the creating the NC code out of this. So I'll go to post selected operations, that is G1. Okay, post selected operations. Make sure both the operations are selected, or you can again click on select all operations and then go to post selected operations. Okay, now it says this particular function is not available in the demo in the home learning version, but that's okay. What we have to do, this is just a single click operation. Okay, this is just a single click operation, and it gives us the MasterCam code. Okay, it gives us the CNC code. Okay, so that's okay. We actually are not doing anything here. Whatever we had to do, we have designed the tool paths. Okay, but since we are using a student version, the evaluation version, this is not available. So I hope you have understood. Okay, we talked about the tool settings, we talked about how to set up the stock, then we went in and selected the mill machine group and in that drill, and then how to set up drilling operation for a through hole and how to set up drilling operation for a hole with specified depth. Okay, so these two drill operations we have seen. I hope you have understood. Hope to see you next time with more such interesting content on computer aided manufacturing using MasterCam for SolidWorks. Thank you.